defense there kind of end of the first in that second quarter. What did you notice about the effort on that end of the floor tonight?
I thought we just had to kind of get control of the pace of the game, figure out how they were going to play. After that first quarter, I thought we did a good job of figuring that part out defensively. Got back in transition, fixed our transition. Defense made it jump. Made them play in a half court offense. And, you know, play to our strengths. That's what we play with.
As a veteran, what does it mean to you to see a rookie seize their opportunity the way that
it's nothing like that. There's no better feeling than that. You know, knowing how much hard work those guys put in, knowing how hard it is to get minutes in this league. Prefer to come out and play the way he played tonight. You know, take our hat off to him.
Well, what's Terrence like just daily in practice when he doesn't know when he's going to get to play, when he's not? What's his deal?
I mean, what you guys saw out there tonight, that's him. I mean, he's non-stop working day in and day out. He listens, take advice. Whatever coach asks of him, he makes it happen, he gets it done. And what you saw tonight wasn't a coincidence. That's, contributed to the work that he always put in, you know, the things that people don't see.
Mel, speaking of rookies, you're part of one of the all-time great draft classes in 03. What do you think about this draft class in general, how they're performing as a whole?
This class now?
Yeah, 2017.
I like it, to be honest with you. I think the future of this NBA is in good hands with these, you know, the young guys that's coming into the league and the way that they're playing, the way that they're finding their own identities. I think the biggest part is, the biggest thing was just be patient. I love the attitude that those guys have coming into this league, the confidence that those guys have, and that's going to continue to grow every year.
The NBA can be such a grind mentally, physically. What's it like to have a night like tonight where it's just
a grind. I got to start getting ready for tomorrow night. Play the Clippers here tomorrow night, so that just goes to show you what this grind is all about.
What to have a night like tonight where it's just an easy,
It looked easy. It wasn't easy though. It looked easy. A lot of work going to make this game look as easy as it was. But it wasn't that easy.
Mel, do you remember so much it felt like when you were told you were going to get your first start in the NBA?
Probably when I got drafted. To be honest with you, I don't remember the first time somebody told me I was going to start, but I remember the first time actually starting and running out there in that court, getting that opportunity, kind of earn my stripes, make my name, play as hard as I can, you know, kind of just be ready for, you know, what the NBA is.
Well, there's so much talk here about
to Russ
or to
anyone
because of that?
I don't answer those questions, to be honest with you. I don't even think Paul is thinking about that at this point. I think he's good where he's at right now. When that time comes, I'm pretty sure you guys have the answer. The answer that you guys are looking for. But as far as Paul goes, I don't think nobody knows what.
Not at all, because
it's not even something that's discussed. It's not even something that's brought up. It's not even something that we can talk about. We might laugh and joke about it tonight. We ran out there on the court, but other than that, it's not something that is even part of our discussion and talk.
Mel, you've talked a lot about when you guys weren't making shots earlier in the year, that eventually the shots are just going to go down for you and for Paul and for Russ. Lately, you guys are all shooting really amazing percentages when you play together. Is there something different clicking, or is it like you were saying before, it's just shots are going down and it's the same stuff?
Well, I mean, of course shots, we have to make shots, but I think it's also us just, I don't want to keep saying figure it out, it's basketball, but I think it was some adjustments that we all had to make in order for all three of us to be successful out there. In order for this team to be successful, we all had to kind of just accept whatever role there was for us. And over the past 3-4 weeks, I think that's something that we came to grips with one another. We talked about it. The coach talked about it with the guys on the team. We talked about it amongst ourselves. And everybody knows their role. Everybody knows what to expect. With that, you're able to hold guys accountable if they're not doing, you know, what was expected of them.
What would you say is your role?
Who am I? I keep that to myself.
It seemed like there was a lot of like, physical and mental work, though, that went into this over the last month or so about, you know, looking at film, working on, you had mentioned, like, working on footwork.
Yeah,
and
I mean,
all sorts of
you
things.
Know, it's the small nuances of that make us, you know, being able to be productive in what we're doing right now. Spots on the court. Learning one another, knowing, learning where guys like to play on the court, passes, knowing, you know, guys' tendencies. So a lot of things goes into kind of how we're playing right now. It'll just start.